Hello, good morning, everybody.
Hi.
You can see us. We can't really see you, but we know what you all look like, and we remember you, and we wish you could be right here with us. I have a different kind of hello song this morning, and it's called Hello, How Are You? And we're not just saying, hello, how are you? We're really asking, how are you? So I'm going to ask everybody to just maybe even close your eyes for a minute and take a deep breath and think of how you are. And you could just think of, how does my body feel? Or you could like, how are my emotions? What am I feeling, sad or angry or happy and wonderful? Or you could be like, how's my body feeling? I feel like a little, you could even say that. You could even say a sound instead of a word. Or I could say I'm sleepy, whatever you're feeling, hungry. Okay. So it goes like this. Hello, 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 how are you? Karen, I'm sleepy. Hello, 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 how are you? I think that's the right tune. Monique.
I'm happy.
All right. And then I'm going to sing it to everybody. All right. So let's take a little minute and think about how you're feeling. Okay. Ready? Hello. 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 How are you? How are you this morning? Thanks for sharing that. It's good to see everybody. Because I'm seeing in my mind.
And let's give ourselves a virtual hug.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love myself so much.
Yay.
Can I give everybody else a virtual hug too?
Yes, please.
There you go. Oh.
Yay. So, welcome back to our Spring Cottage Montessori movies and TV show. And... yeah, it's still spring, which is awesome. And things are growing. Actually, Karen, how are your seeds doing?
Wait till you see this. I couldn't even believe it when I walked over there. I showed you it. They were having some pretty good roots the other day, but it's getting even longer and bigger. And do you notice how much bigger the leaf is? It really looks like the seed part is going to pop right off. And then I bet it will come up here. I'm already thinking that I should find a little pot with some dirt so I can start growing it in dirt. I think it'll be happier when it gets a little bigger. Let's see the other side. This was really amazing to me. Whoops, turn it this way. All those lacy little roots that are down there.
Wow. Quite
amazing. And that leaf is getting bigger too. It's so fun to watch things grow. Remember, if you make one of these at home, it's important that your paper towel is at least several thicknesses that you've folded it up, because you want to push it against the side of the glass. That's keeping it warm between the little seed, between the glass and the paper towel. And with some sun shining on it and being wet, that's what makes it grow.
And when would people be thinking about planting them in dirt, Karen?
And it starts to pop out. I'm going to wait till it pops out the top probably. And then I'm going to have to very carefully kind of wiggle that whole paper towel out. And I'm probably going to plant the whole paper towel. I may take off those lemon seeds because they're not doing anything. But I'm going to plant the whole paper towel in under some dirt. I'll probably show you when I do it.
Oh, that's exciting. So keep waiting. If you're growing seeds at your house, wait until they start popping out before you put anything in a pot with any soil.
I mean, you could do an experiment and just put seeds in the soil if you want to. That might be an interesting thing to do. Grow some like this and then try to dig, bury some in a little pot of dirt and see which one grows first.
Ooh, I love doing experiments. It's really fun. And just a reminder, go look out at trees. I was so excited this morning because my pear tree is flowering. I'm going to take a picture of it.
Good, because I'm going to put some pictures online of our forsythia here and our azaleas. And you won't believe this, but in our vegetable garden, our little rectangular garden where we dig, and there are about 6 daffodils growing. And I didn't plant them there. I don't even know. They just popped up and I'm loving them.
So I wonder if some squirrels dug them up and took them over there and just dropped them.
Yeah, you never know.
Very interesting. Wow. All right. Well, thanks, Karen. Let's go back to you.
Well, I have a couple activities this morning. Nothing to make, but something to just pastimes, things to do when, you know, for fun. And one of them is, I was calling it charades, but charades is more of a grown-up game where you try to act out the name of a story or a book or something, and it takes longer and it's a little harder. And what I'm doing is really pantomime. Pantomime is where you act something out and the other person tries to guess what you're acting out. And usually in pantomime, you're not supposed to make any sounds, just your movement. But I am going to maybe add a sound after I do the movement. So I'll see if you can guess just from the movement. And then if you can't, then I'll just say the sound at the end, just to, as a little clue. Okay, here's my first one. Did you guess cat? You're right. Here's another one. Got something back here that's going like this. It's my tail. Did you guess that one?
Dog. Whoop.
All right, here's one. This is very simple. You're right, it's a horse. I've got 2 more. Okay.
Honey. I wondered if it was the Easter bunny.
Good question. Last one. Yeah. Yeah, it's a cow.
Cows eat a lot of grass.
Yeah, so that's a different way you could do. We were doing riddles like what is black and white and looks like a horse. What do you think, Monique?
Black and white and looks like a horse. Are you talking about a zebra?
So this is just a different way to do that kind of a game. Instead of asking with words, you're acting it out and then people can guess.
Now, can I do one, Karen?
Oh, sure. Oh, that's right. You don't have to just do animals, do you?
Oh. Do you know?
Brushing your teeth. Oh, here's one. Here's one. I had a little cell phone there, didn't I? So you can do all kinds of things where you act out and you try to get people to guess. And it's something you could do if you're on Zoom, like with your grandma or somebody, you could do pretend games like that. Monique and I are going to do a different kind of game now, and it's called Rock, Paper, Scissors. And I was wondering if maybe you had heard about that game. And it's something where you just put your hand out, basically. All you need is your body. You don't need anything else to play it. And what you do is you make your hand into a fist, and with your friend, you go 1, 2, 3, and then you're going to open your hand. Well, in some cases, you're going to do one of 3 things with your hand. You could keep it like this. That's a rock. You could, after you go 1, 2, 3, you could put 2 fingers out. That's the scissors. And you could go 1, 2, 3, and just put a flat hand out. That's the paper. So to win the game, It's either if I'll show you the different things that beat the other things. What do you think? Scissors beats paper because it can cut it up, right? And rock is the paper wins over rock because it can wrap up the rock. And the rock beats the scissors because it can crush the scissors. Okay, so should we try it, Monique?
Let's try it.
A little hard to do online with a friend because it's not, we're not doing it the exact same time. Our internet is a little bit different timing. Okay, 1, 2, 3, go. Ah! And this happens sometimes too. It's a tie. We don't know who would win that. So should we try again?
Let's try again.
1, 2, 3, go. Ah! Oh, we did it again. We tied again. All right. 1, 2, 3, go. Oh, so Monique is crushing my scissors. Oh, she wins. Let's try it again. 1, 2, 3, and go. Oh, now I'm crushing Monique's scissors. Let's try one last time. 1, 2, 3, go. Again, she wins. It's just kind of a silly, fun thing to do. And it really doesn't matter who wins, does it? It's just fun to do it. I kind of like, I even like doing it just by myself where I go, 1, 2, 3, boom. You just make things pop out of your hand like that. So those are some games. We're gonna do a couple different circle songs today. Bringing you into the circle area. The furniture movers have already moved the furniture, which is great. You know who the furniture movers are? Me and Gary. All right. I bet you remember this one. In the mood for jumping? I am. All right. 5 little monkeys jumping on the bed. 1 fell off and he bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, "No more monkeys jumping on the bed." 4 little monkeys jumping on the bed. 1 fell off and he bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, "No more monkeys jumping on the bed." 3 little monkeys jumping on the bed. 1 fell off and she bumped her head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, "No more monkeys jumping on the bed." 2 little monkeys jumping on the bed. 1 fell off and she bumped her head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, "No more monkeys jumping on the bed." 1 more monkey was jumping on the bed. She fell off and she bumped her head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, "That's what you get from jumping on the bed." I hope you're not jumping on the bed at home. Oh, I was wondering if you know this or some people remember it from last year. It goes like this. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout. Tip me over and pour me out. If I go like this, I'm a sugar bowl. All right. You sing a song and I'll sing a song and we'll sing a song together. You sing a song and I'll sing a song in rain or sunny weather. You stomp your feet and I'll stomp my feet and we'll stomp our feet together. You stomp your feet and I'll stomp my feet in rain or sunny weather. You spin around and I'll spin around and we'll spin around together. You spin around and I'll spin around in rain or sunny weather. And right now we are talking about son, I'm going to play a dance party song about walking on sunshine. Let's see if I can find it. There we go.
A little quiet, Karen.
Got it all the way up.
Oh, wow. That's good.
Oh, I don't have this part on there. There we go. Monique was sitting during that song. It's because she's still got a little bit of a headache.
It's getting better, though.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear that. I'm sure she'll be back to normal pretty soon, but she's going to take it easy today, which is always a good idea when you're not feeling well, right? Everybody should do that if you're not feeling well. Well, I talked to, I feel like I talked to a couple people recently who for Easter, they got eggs that had dinosaurs inside. And we usually think about, what animal do we usually think about when we think about laying eggs? Could it be this one? I usually think of a chicken when I think of an animal laying eggs. But as this book says, chickens aren't the only ones. And I did try to find this book online so you could see it a little bit better, but I'm going to do my best to let you see it. So, guess who else? Guess who else lays eggs? It might be an alligator and it might be a crocodile. I'm not sure. I love this picture too. All the chickens upside and downside. Chickens aren't the only one. By Ruth Heller. She not only wrote this book, she drew all these beautiful pictures. So, chickens lay the eggs you buy. Let's see if I change this to speaker view, if that helps you in our video. Yeah. The eggs you boil or fry. Or dye. Ooh, did some of you dye eggs for Easter? Or leave alone so you can see what grew inside quite naturally. Chickens aren't the only ones. Every bird, wild or tame, does the same. Turkeys do, and ducks and geese and swans. The ostrich lays the largest egg. When we read that book, The Most Wonderful Egg, it said that one of the chickens, one of the hens, her egg was even larger than an ostrich egg, and that in real life, an ostrich egg is the largest. And the hummingbird lays the smallest. Can you just barely see it in here underneath the ostrich egg? That's the difference in size between a hummingbird egg and an ostrich egg. Chickens aren't the only ones. Most snakes lay eggs, and lizards too. Where are we? There we go. Look at that. And crocodiles and turtles do. This way. Crocodiles and turtles do. And dinosaurs, who are extinct, but they were reptiles too. So it's not just, I mean, I suppose if you had a toy egg, you could put a Lego guy, or you could put anything inside a toy egg. But when you put a dinosaur inside a plastic egg, that really happened. Dinosaurs really did lay eggs back when dinosaurs existed. Frogs and toads and salamanders lay eggs. And when they hatch, they're tadpoles who grow legs and climb a lily pad just like their mom and dad. They don't have claws or scaly skins. They are called amphibian. I bet you remembered that. Fish eggs float up to the surface or sink down to the bottom of the ocean floor. All kinds of fish. This mother seahorse lays her eggs into the father's pouch, and he keeps them there until they hatch, and then he's through. I think that's nice of him, don't you? These fathers, too, are helping out by guarding eggs protected by that foamy mass that's floating by, and they won't leave until they're sure that all the eggs have hatched. You can tell this is an older book because they're talking about dads helping out, or actually they're just being dads, taking care of their children. These don't look like eggs to me. Centered a little bit better. But they were laid in the sea. This one was laid by a shark. Can you believe it? That's what a shark's egg looks like. And this one by a ray is a mermaid's purse, they say. Somebody found that in the ocean and said, that looks just like a mermaid's purse. So we're going to call the ray's eggs that. And here's some grown-up sharks and grown-up rays. The octopus is said to shed 100,000 eggs and then to hang them up in strings attached to rocks or caves. Looks pretty beautiful, actually. Look at that. It's hanging up there upside down. I like that pink thing. The moon snail. The moon snail's eggs are mixed with sand to form this collar-looking band. spiders wrap their eggs in sacks, and snails, you know, are very slow, but they lay eggs that hatch and grow.
Spider and snails. Both laying eggs too.
Whoa, insects who have six legs and lay many different kinds of eggs. This one, look at all these bugs. This little egg, we see this little yellow egg. That will grow into a, it will hatch into a hungry caterpillar who will grow and grow and grow and then climb a stem and change into this, which is called a chrysalis, and change again one summer morn. This one should show before I turn in all these different insects. Holy moly. So the chrysalis will change again one summer morn, and that's how a butterfly is born. Animals with fur or hair who nurse their young and don't lay eggs are known as mammals or mammalia. But these are two exceptions, and they both live in Australia. The spiny anteater and the duckbill platypus. They're the only mammals that we know of who also lay eggs. We're mammals, we have hair, right? And the moms nurse, we moms nurse our young with milk from our bodies. Usually we don't lay eggs, right? You weren't hatched from an egg, and neither was I, but these are two mammals who do lay eggs. Chickens aren't the only ones. There's no more to discuss. Everyone who lays an egg is called oviparous. So oviparous is the word for animals who lay eggs. Oviparous. Interesting word. Animals who don't lay eggs have babies born and alive and well. But that's another tale to tell. And Ruth Heller also wrote a book, here it is again, wrote a book called Animals Alive and Well, and maybe we'll be reading that in the future. But for today, chickens aren't the only ones. That's important to remember. Well, I think we're at the end of our time together for today. It was great to be here with you and share some fun things to do. And we will see you again next time.
Bye, everybody.